Hello, my beautiful people. Welcome back to our channel. It's another late night, and HOA and I are in here. Rain's about to start, and we're gonna have some fun, I hope. Before we get started, I wanted to show you the dried results from last week's pour, our inner sandwich. That new fun sandwich pour technique that I came up with that I really am very, very pleased with. If you guys remember, or if you hadn't seen that one, we did a sandwich pour inside a regular layered cup, and the only two colors inside the sandwich were a darker blue and a brilliant blue. And I wanted to really see if that would isolate the blue into some parts only, but not the entire painting. And I really feel like that was accomplished, and it came out really, really pretty. Some of these cells are just amazing. Like in here, HOA, can you get these with the really darker, deep crimson ring around that lighter strawberry color? And this whole edge is beautiful. These cells in here are just beautiful. I'm very, so very, very happy with this piece. And can't talk, apparently. So. But I wanted to show you guys the dried results of this one. Really, really happy with how it came out. So, okay, let's get started. Tonight we are going to be working on another one of those inner sandwich pours. With that one, I really like how it came out. I kind of wanted to simplify the palette a little bit more to see if we could isolate that center inner sandwich part. So that's what we're going to attempt to do tonight. I'll show you the colors real quick. This is a custom kind of indigo violet. We had used one of a drip color indigo violet as the base for that, the flow extender, and I really like it. So this is a bunch of different things mixed up together to create this beautiful indigo violet color. Really happy with that. I also have this Febio iridescent violet blue that I guess is the sister to the iridescent red blue that I've been loving on lately. So this one is really pretty, and I'm hoping this is going to come out beautiful too. So that's the iridescent violet blue from Febio. This is another custom color. This was that ruby that we used in that one, and I added a little bit of an alizarin crimson, actually by Febio, to it also to give me more volume of paint. That's a very pretty color, and I'm confident it's going to dry similar to that. And then this one, we have our 24 karat gold from Deco Art Americana Decor Metallics, my lovely showgirl. Okay, and we have some titanium white. My pouring medium tonight is my Golden's Heavy Gel Gloss and Floetrol pouring medium, mound on a mound, and then sinks into itself very quickly. Nice and thick and creamy and velvety. Okay, so we have here a 20 by 24 inch gallery wrapped canvas. I have taped and pinned the back, and I have painted the sides and edges. So let's layer some cups. We're going to use 2 9-ounce cups, and we're going to layer them the same. So this is where I need to think what I want to do for the sandwich part. I do want to use the white, and I want to use that ruby and the gold. So that leaves these two that I want to use on the outer layers. Okay? So let's start with some of that. Let's switch it up a little bit and create a lot of contrast. We'll start with a little bit of the iridescent violet blue. And now we're going to come into this indigo violet. Lots of contrast there. Okay, now we're going to do a layer of white for our first layer of our sandwich bread. And instead of just drizzling it off the stick, I'm actually going to pour it because I want a little bit more in there. And again, when you're doing a sandwich pour with white, you want to use bolder colors that are going to show up. If you use something very pale or light against the white, it's not going to show up as much. So, boom. Okay, now we're going to do our other layer of white. Thank you. This will actually be interesting because the only gold that's in there is that one layer. Okay, now we're gonna do... I actually wanna put this on the... all right. We're
gonna... I just wing it.
I did have a plan, I promise, I swear. Okay. The indigo violet. And the iridescent violet blue.
You know what they say, life's what's happening when you're making plans.
Well, what I was thinking of is my base coat color, which is this, which is also a darker purple. So I didn't want to have the dark indigo violet on the last layer and then have this as my base coat color. So at least there'll still be some contrast between that violet blue and that. That's what I was thinking of. There was method to my madness.
You tell me there always is. So.
Yeah, there usually is. The wheels are turning, I swear. It has been a pretty hard week. I wanted to take a moment and thank you all so much for all of your love and support regarding Baxter passing away and HOA, and I just wanted to thank you. We love you guys a lot, and it means a lot to us. So, okay, I'm not going to talk about that for the rest of the video. So, here we go. We're going to put down our base coat. The last time I didn't put down both of them, and I regretted it, so we're actually going to put down two puddles, and we're going to tilt them out. Base for our inner sandwich pour, take two. I like that color combination though, that's really cool. Are you ready, husband of awesomeness?
Yes, my love.
Here we go. So there's number one. Do some magic taps. Just wait a second. And I have noticed with the sandwich pours that I do, they're usually really, really pretty. So what I've taken to doing is just lifting the cup up and looking at it, and if there's really big blocks of solid color, then I'll lip it, but I don't just lip it automatically because it is actually really beautiful. All right, here we go, darling, ready?
Yes.
So we're just gonna put a little bit of lip. Ooh, that's pretty. Ooh, I'm excited. Looks like a bird. All right, we're gonna do this one over here. Are you ready, husband of awesomeness?
Aye, lass, that I am.
Now this one, I may lip it through that white area just to break that up a little bit. Here we go. And again through this one. That's really cool. That's really pretty. I'm happy. Oh wow, the cups are so cute too.
Got a floral thing going on there.
There's actually a bird with a wing going up. Okay, let's go around this with our flow extender. I'm happier with the amount of flow extender that I had down, or base coat that I had down, than I was last time. I feel like it's gonna spread around a lot easier. I'm really happy with this. I'm gonna do one thing and just kind of pull that out a little bit. I don't know if you can see. You see the bird now?
Yes, now I see.
I'm actually gonna take this and go this way too. Okay. Cool. Let's tilt this out. Wait all day. Like a candle, I just burn away. All we really have is time. All we really have is time. I don't know. bird's still there. He's safe. That's pretty cool. Okay, so now in terms of the experiment with the sandwich board, let me put my hands off. Now that we've tilted it out. So this one we used that ruby crimson color and the gold. I remember that was the only place we had the gold, and look, here in that beak. Make his beak just a bit longer. Here in the beak and on the head, I don't know if you guys can see that bird shape, but and over here, not as much, but I think that's because we lit the cup through it, but we are getting some cells with the gold and that alizarin crimson. And then of course we have the iridescent blue violet and that darker indigo violet, which I really am loving this part, and I think this is gonna sell up even more. Not sure I like this down there, but I like all the rest of it, and I don't really want to tilt it too much more because I don't want to distort this kind of swan bird shape. What do you think? You think I should take this down a little bit more or leave it?
I think it's fine the way it is, but...
Okay, I'll leave it. I'm okay with it how it is.
Kind of looks like a puffin.
A puffin? Okay, so this is cool. I like this. I'm very happy with how this looks. I will show you guys when it's dry. Thank you so much for being here with us tonight. Hope you have a wonderful, wonderful day. We'll see you real soon. It's cool. I like all these like twists in there. And I like how the color is coming through in that little pink part, the baby pink in there. That's the iridescent blue violet. So that's gonna be super color shifty. Cool, I like a lot. Okay, so this is a couple days later. It is not completely dry, but it's getting there. The center is still pretty wet, but this came out really cool. Very happily surprised with this. I love that duck swan head thing. Very, very pretty. I love these colors. That indigo violet that we made and the iridescent blue violet or violet blue. Really, really beautiful contrast. I love how deep and dark the indigo violet is. You see our base coat color on there a little bit too. And as far as this inner sandwich part, there's our red and our gold, the ruby. And along here a little bit. And along this top edge also. So remember, the gold was only in that one layer of the inside of the sandwich part. Pretty fun. I really like this one. I love these parts up here where it's kind of galactic. And that indigo violet has sort of spread out a little bit and got the little cells coming through. It is very, very pretty up in the corner. And I just love that darker color sort of gives it so much contrast and makes the lighter colors really pop. So this one came out cool. I still see the bird, the duck. It makes me laugh, so that's fun. I really like this piece. I'm definitely going to play with this technique some more. I have some more ideas for a couple of different variations that I think are going to be a lot of fun. And I just wanted to take a moment and say thank you so much. I have been reading, working my way through all the comments that you guys have left regarding Baxter, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart. I was worried that I wasn't going to be able to read them without sobbing and crying like crazy, but they've actually been very, very comforting, and you guys are so lovely and so beautiful, and thank you for sharing your stories with me, and I'm sorry that we made you guys sad or made you cry, but it is very comforting to know that people all over the world loved him and loved to watch him be silly just like we did. So thank you so much. Still pretty hard. We're still devastated. It's so quiet. It's driving me crazy. And we miss him so much. But I just wanted to say thank you to you guys, because you guys are just amazing. And I feel all the hugs. I feel all the love. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart. So we love you guys a lot. We'll see you for the next video. Have a great day. Bye-bye.